Good morning. So far income tax is concerned, there are three categories of professionals who are bound to submit their return even if they did not have accessible income. You can file your balance sheet and income tax return stating that no taxable income. That is mandatory under Income Tax Act. But still, several government servants, tax are being paid, that is being managed by the department itself. But you never concentrate to follow that. That will cause some slight repercussion when you retire and get some service benefits. Therefore, try to concentrate your income tax particulars. That apart, today a case of income tax I would like to discuss with you to understand the primary factors and the process how tax are being assessed and what all are the ways for penalizing the assessee for improper submission of accounts, and the tribunal relief and appellate tribunal relief, then High Court, then Supreme Court. That is the process. So I would like to discuss with this case. AR 2020, Supreme Court 2137. Basir Ahmad Sisodia was an income tax officer. Section 143, Class 2 and 68 were referred. A short case was that the appellant was served with a notice under 143, Class 2 for the year 98-99 on appraising the assessment order, which was passed on 30-11-2000. Trading account and credits in the assessment order. The officer inter alia, while relaying the balance sheet and the book account, took note of credits amounting to 2,26,000. The officer treated that amount as cash credit under section 68 of the 1961. Therefore, that what is different between cash credit and other credit must be understood. They say this income of creditors was under some different head. They have imposed some penalty, then they went to income tax commissioner appeals, Jodhpur. That was partly allowed, and then they went to appellate tribunal. Then thereafter, under section 260A of the Income Tax Act provides appeal before the High Court. You would have noticed the cost items, cost list, there will be tax cases appeal. The High Court dismissed the appeal, that resulted Supreme Court to look into. The Supreme Court held that the appellate authority's observation that there was no concealment of income or furnishing any inaccurate particulars of income, and accordingly the penalty order was cancelled. They say the non-recognized creditors, he has shown certain amount from non-recognized creditors. So there may be a recognized creditors and a non-recognized creditors. That should also be understood. Then unregistered dealers, he obtained the affidavit from all these unregistered dealers and their statement, and that was accepted. Therefore, the Supreme Court allowed the appeal by setting aside the High Court order and the assessment modified by the appellate authority, CITA, was remain undisturbed. So this is the way the tax cases are being worked out. So you have some knowledge, so that at least there was any case, or nowadays there is possibility of luck from heaven. Even if you do not know anything about any area of law, if you are continuously accompanying politicians, or your relative is a politician, or one of your relative is a government servant dealing with the appointment of standing councils, you may get that post. That for that purpose, at least you should have some basic primary knowledge. So, but there are these fields are being occupied by the continuous relations, relatives, and in Tamil Nadu, almost all North Indians are on seat representing income tax cases. In income tax cases are coming under finance department. Therefore, the finance department and some few departments have their own process of appointing standing counsel. And for other departments, law, Ministry of Law and Justice appoints that on recommendations of the Politburo of political parties in these cases. However, initially I was shocked. I was thinking that it should be regularized and stopped. But unfortunately, after days, months, years are rolled on, I understood that the advocates who do not have cases were given a golden opportunity, and some of the advocates, by learning, by concentrating, by training themselves, became very improvised counsels. And that makes me happy. And later on, when they were left out of that post, they became a very good, successful lawyer in defending the department also later on. So let that be go on. If it is luck and this were not happening, sometimes it happens even without basic knowledge. Some standing counsels, without wearing robe, and crores of rupees, being a politician's recommendation and politicians, these all are happening. Normally, I used to represent before the court that these booth agents are appointed. Yes, sometimes this is the way. If it is not regular, time and again, Supreme Court issuing order, High Court of Chennai has already issued order to regulate this posting. Despite that, without holding inquiry, they only count year of practice, whether they are regularly practicing or not. What had happened when the Bar Council of India introduced the process of system for continuity of service, they must produce the records to show that he was continuously practicing. What the advocate did with the help of court staff, by greasing them, they obtained old records, wakalat. They add their name and get certified copy of that manipulation, and that they have managed as this examination for eligibility with All India Bar eligibility certificate for the new entrants, how they are managing it. That apart from that, there should be oral interview also to assess the if some advocates are even without primary knowledge or continue to practice, that causes much deterioration in the profession standard. I hope so. that bar council will do something. Festival says good.